Globe man, tell us right now where you flyin'. Globe man, what's it like in Cayman Islands?
Good people, beautiful people of the world, it's your girl Shirley Hero, and I'm always rapping What's Good Live, and today we're at the Brew Bistro Lounge in Westlands to talk to the artists that are going to be representing Village Link Up happening Sunday, October 15th at the Alchemist. Let's go hear what they have to say and enjoy some good food and drinks. Come on.
Way too stressful. I can't deal with the stress, mate. Put a ring on my girlfriend. Yep, they go my best mate. Don't compare me to these other rap guys. We are not the same. They be telling lies, talking about trap.
Always repping What's Good Live, and today is a special occasion. We are at the Bel Air Brunch, where we have just eaten a delectable meal, and we're about to talk about the music industry. But before that, we need to introduce ourselves. So Kirby, please go ahead, start.
Kirby, you know me if you live in Nairobi.
Hey.
But I'm Kirby. I'm an artist and a revolutionary. Yeah. I'm pleased to be here.
Hey, my name's Brad Jacuzzi, the Coco Master, the Pretty Rasta. I'm just going to tell you something, Mr. Oya, Mr. First Seen These Cocos. And it's happy to be here. I can't wait for Village Link Up. It's going to be real lit. We're making more juice.
Yes.
Mikel Amin, the world changer, all the way from London town, repping for the Village Link Up. It's going to be dope. World changer life, man. Hey!
This one's heavy.
Yeah, that's really heavy. Yeah, my name is Bodhani, drummer queen, singer, rapper, drummer, all around boss lady from Nairobi. Excited to be here.
Amazing. So, as we get started, I just want everyone to say what village they're from. I'll start. My village is from Muranga. And proud.
Hey. Gang. Same village. Wagwan. Ohoroako. You see me?
Vihiga. Vihiga in Western Province. County. Is it county now?
The West.
Yeah. County, yeah. County, West Side.
So my village is all the way in the Caribbean. We're from a little place called Mespo in St. Vincent. So big up all the Vincentians out there. Dunno. Pata. Yeah, big up on yourself, man. Dunno.
Me, I'm born and raised in Nairobi. So Nairobi my village, Nairobi my home, Nairobi the dream.
NBI, y'all. All right, so let's get right into it. Hello! Shout out to Bel Air and Bel Air Brunch. Okay!
Hello!
So, with that being said, are artists within their chosen music industries, you being the UK, Madhani, you being Switzerland and Kenya, and Barack and Kirby, you guys being Kenya and East Africa, are artists within their chosen music industries doing enough to globalize their markets? Mm-hmm. Do you guys understand
yes,
the question?
I think I understand your question. But then before I answer, let me get a little bit of that. Thank you, my brother. Yeah, no, I feel like whether they're doing enough or not, they soon realize that the only way for them to truly maximize on their talent is to do that. Do you know what I'm saying? I feel like artists who haven't yet understood this globalization and the kind of new era that we're living in are falling behind. And old artists who had old success models are falling behind because, again, they don't understand that. You know, the fact that you've got Barack over here coming from the States, Madhani traveling from here to other places, me being from London and traveling to Europe and East Africa, it's because we now understand that what we're saying, even though it has a local and a very national flavor to it, it's something that relates on a much wider scale. So you no longer have to be within your immediate constituents. The world is like huge, you know what I mean? And another thing, the reason why that's great is because, you know, I know you can relate, where we're from, rappers, it's like picking up lentils out of a bucket. Like, that's how many there are. They're like stones on the floor. They're like sand. Everyone rap, everyone wants to be an artist. And so unless you truly, you know, really represent yourself, like down to your fingerprint, that unique identity, then you're not really going to maximize.
And Madhani, you've been in the music industry for so long, and to say that you are a pioneer of the creative industry in Kenya is an understatement. I feel like you've put Kenya on the map as an international destination for music and for entertainment. What are some of the things that you're frustrated with? Like, you know, it's 2017. It feels like we haven't reached there yet. How do you feel? Like, what do you feel like we're lacking, and what should we do better?
I think First, I have to say that there's been a lot of growth. There's been a lot of movement, and there's certainly more space than there was when we started, like 2008. I think there's been movement. I think the place where I still feel frustrated is this single narrative of what is Kenya, what is Kenyan, what is acceptable. I still feel frustrated when I listen to artists making music, and the whole intention of the music is to be big in Kenya.
Honestly, like, you have been the key that has opened the door to creative entrepreneurship. And you better put that on a t-shirt. No, because without someone as young, as vivacious, and as hardworking, and as creative as you, we would feel like it's impossible to accomplish. Yeah. Yet you have done it consistently for 10 years.
Very much so normalized it. And just, everybody's heard of how Blanket started. I mean, when I heard how it started, because I didn't know that's how it started. Because when I got here 2 years ago, I kind of just came into this huge. It was a huge event by this time. But when I heard how the first one started, I mean, it's crazy. Basically, if you don't know, Blinkin started with like 30 people, like 20 people in somebody's backyard, and now they're in Uganda, Kenya, elsewhere, Rwanda. Tell them.
Let's get that off real quick.
Yes.
That's amazing.
But with that being said, I feel like there's not enough Madoni the Drummer Queens. You know, exactly. Out of all the years where there's been so many of these artists who came out and did so many great things, she's one of the few who've actually, you know, there's a lot of other things she's doing for the scene and definitely cultivating it. And that's what I was saying. I think people, you know, sometimes slack. Sometimes some of the higher ups could have done a little bit more. But definitely, I feel like with our new generation, with this new Nairobi scene, it's all love. Everybody's collaborating. Mm-hmm. Everybody's working together. Mm-hmm. It's going to be an incredible thing. And now it's only to the top.
Exactly.
I wanted to say something on that. Yeah. I was even talking to Blinky about this the other day, and like just seeing how much again he's so, because he was the first artist I connected with as a friend and as a collaborator as well. You know, and just seeing how people, you know, when you come in ignorant, you get to take everything at face value. Yeah. Do you know what I mean? And so to hear me saying his name, oh yeah, I was just dealing with Binky, and how much people respect him. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And to even hear you put his name in the music shows how you revere him. And I was saying to him, like, for me coming in here to Nairobi and hearing the frustrations of the younger artists and even some of the more established artists who still can't penetrate globally, I was like, this just reminds me of where grime was in like 2002. Mm-hmm. That's what literally it is. And I was saying, like, because I'm from the grime scene where we didn't call it grime. We were just doing it.
Yeah.
It was coming from, these people don't mess with us, and these lot don't like us in this scene.
Yeah.
We want to talk about what we're going through in the hood, and we want to, this is our sound. Right. We didn't know it was a sound. We just creating from all of our influences, hip hop, dance hall, dub, drum and bass, and garage, and we're just like, yeah. Do you know what I mean? And we cultivated, and that's why early grime didn't have a specific, the only thing that was specific was the tempo.
Yeah.
Sound was tempo. Was all over the place. Yeah. And that's what the beautiful thing about us, and I was saying that don't be disheartened. Do you know what I mean? Don't be disheartened. This is this pain, this resistance you're getting from the top, it only allows you to cultivate and grow more and crystallize what's naturally going on anyway.
So like, where do you see the future of Kenya's music industry and of Kenya's entertainment industry or East Africa's industry? What is next for us? What do you think is coming up?
First of all, look at the festivals we have right now. I looked at the lineup for Africa Nouveau today and I was like, what? Temi Dolphins, Sichangi. And I was like, this is exactly, we're actually bringing the world to us right now. That's exactly what we're doing. And also another revelation came to me while we're talking. And now I realize it doesn't matter if you're Kenyan and you were raised wherever, because this panel here represents Kenyans' curation of art in any circumstance you put them.
The oldest remains of human life,
come on,
is in Kenya. Turkana, that's the first, the oldest known, the oldest known Homo sapien. This is Kenya. Kenya invented humanity. I always say this when I travel.
Say it louder.
Kenya invented human beings, y'all, right? Shout out to Kenya. And so I'm not surprised about this role, that Kenya is then the congregator of humanity.
Oh.
I'm not surprised at all.
No, I'm just with you. I'm being a witness.
Yeah, and that you're here, and that you're going to have this beautiful experience over these next days with everybody who's coming for World Changer, and that the whole reason you created this is for people to connect.
Yeah.
And without a dedicated end goal, except being that connections will produce something, something will manifest of those connections, you are exactly where you need to be. This thing that you're doing here is not a one-off.
No.
You came home, and this thing that you're going to start here, and the way you're going to affect it, check it in like 5 years. Check the thing that will have come from here. Kenya is everything.
Kenya is everything. I like that.
It's amazing.
We need to cheers to Kenya.
We need to raise our glasses to the 2-5.
Listen, one of you artists in here, if you don't do it, I'll do it, but someone needs to put it on a t-shirt. Kenya is everything. Yeah. I love that.
You guys, cheers to Kenya.
Dope, man. That's so dope.
Kenya is everything. Thank you guys so much for tuning into the Village Link Up Artist Talk Back with Bel Air Brunch. Make sure to follow Bel Air East Africa online so you can join us at the next brunch. They've got delicious food and delicious drink, and you can enjoy everything for only $1,500. Ladies and gentlemen, we will see you on October 15th at The Alchemist with these artists and so many more. And you. And we will see you guys. Make sure to get your tickets on mook.com or else it's 2,000 at the gate, 15 in advance. You guys, thank you so much. Cheers. Kenya is everything.
Kenya is everything.
Cheers.